Welcome everybody, it's Dr. Adam here and it's extraction day. In this instructional video, I'm going to be covering the basics of small scale honey extraction. And really, I'm going to be showing you today exactly what we do in our own operation. So I'm going to take you through the tools that we use, kind of what are the options available to you at a small scale. We'll talk a little bit about extractors, basically tangential versus radial and what you want to be thinking about then. And then I'm going to show you basically a run through the full process that we go through when we extract. So stay tuned and we'll show you this process. As we get started with extraction, let's cover the basic things you're going to need for a small scale extraction operation. Now this can be something that's anywhere from, you know, a couple beehives all the way on up to, well, we're at around 70 beehives. So it, you know, when we've been using this same process since we were at about 5 or 6 beehives. We invested a little bit extra in some of this equipment, particularly extractor early on, and we've basically built on to kind of that early investment and really figured out kind of a nice assortment of tools that are real basic that allow you to get through quite a lot of honey. I mean, last year harvested somewhere around 1,300 pounds of honey. So we use this process for that. And it's a really hands-on process. But let me show you kind of the tools that we use. So one of the things that I have here, this is a bucket. This is gonna be an uncapping bucket that we're gonna use. There's lots of different versions of this. You can get a little small plastic uncapping tanks, but we've used this for years. And this is essentially a piece that fits on to the side of the lid or the side of the bucket area and allows you to place a frame right here and uncap into it. And you can see down in that bucket, there's cappings down in there from a harvest we just did. So this is gonna be where you're gonna be doing your uncapping of your frames. Now, in order to do that uncapping, you need a tool in order to do that. And there's a lot of different tools that you can select from, but I'm gonna show you kind of what are the basic ones that are out there, and they're always changing, so just keep that in mind. But some of the basic ones, your most basic tool is going to be a scratcher, and that is the most basic uncapping tool that you can get. And I'll show you how this works, each one of these works here in just a moment. But this basically scratches the frame, or scratches the caps on the frames, and allows them to be punctured so that the honey can escape during the extraction process. This is a tool that you will absolutely need no matter what you're doing for uncapping. Whether it's you're using something more sophisticated like this tool, a hot knife, or you're using an uncapping machine, this is the thing that you use in areas where the uncappers don't catch. So oftentimes you'll have sunken in areas of a frame, particularly with wax foundation. They can sometimes get warped and you'll have low areas. You'll need to use a scratcher to get in those low areas where your knives and your chain uncappers won't be able to reach. So this is a tool that you absolutely need. Other tools that are out there and just that I've acquired over the years, this is a tool that's been pretty popular for the last couple years, and I'll show you how this works, but the basic idea is that your frame, this comes along your frame, and these shark teeth catch the cappings and pull them off very nicely, while this is a guide right here that allows you to guide right along the cappings as you're going along. It's a nice tool. The thing that I found is that you need to really keep this thing clean while you're using it. The more it gets gunked up, it just gets impossible to use and you end up dragging across frames and causing a mess. Another style is the roller or puncture style. This basically uses a bunch of spines on a roller and you roll it back and forth across a frame in order to puncture the cappings. The thing that I've found about this thing over the years is that it really macerates a lot of the wax, which makes a little bit more work for the bees, and it also makes a lot more work for us as we're straining out wax as honey's coming out of the extractor, because this leaves a ton of debris on the frame itself. And so if you're using this solely as a way to uncap, you're gonna have a ton of wax coming off as you're extracting, and that's just more work for you on the back end as you're trying to strain that wax out to get your final raw honey product. The last thing that we use, and this is something that we've had for many, many years, is a hot knife. The hot knife really is, for a small scale beekeeper, a really nice investment. It allows you to literally cut through the cappings and it leaves a very clean frame that bees can refill nearly immediately. There's basically no work involved in fixing those wax frames when you put them back on after you're done with extraction. It's a heated knife, And they do have different versions of this where you can actually control the heat level. This is a basic version where there's no heat control on here. And this is just a great tool to have. The other thing that you're gonna need for the real basic stuff is a strainer. So we use strainers to get the big parts out. And these stainless steel strainers are really nice to have to base. This is what we use as it's coming out of the extractor to get B parts, wax. Sometimes you have little pieces of wood from broken frames in there. Anything like that, this two-part strainer will pick up. Now, this is not a filter. These are strainers. When you get into filtration, you're talking hundreds of microns as far as the size of filters. So this is it takes out the big stuff, but it leaves your pollen, those pollen fragments in there, which is what consumers want when they get raw honey. So this is a really nice tool to have. I like to have a couple of these on hand because you'll be switching between these as this gets filled up with wax. Really nice system. The other things you're going to want as you're getting going is a set of spatulas, really because you're going to be trying to move stuff around in the extractor. The extractors will have residual honey that will accumulate at the bottom that you can't get out through the outlet, and so you'll use spatulas to kind of move those along as well. Always want to have gloves. You need something for sanitation. And so you want to sanitize all your surfaces before you do that. We tend to use the Lysol wipes for a lot of our sanitation of all of the surfaces before we get started. And then the last thing I'm going to talk about is this little tool right here, which is a refractometer. The refractometer is a tool that we use to determine the water content in honey. If honey is below 18% water content, it will not ferment. This is a nice tool to use to be able to tell if your honey's a little too high in water content or not. Typically, if you're harvesting capped frames, it's not much of an issue, but these will cap honey at a higher water content than 18%, just depending on what the floral resource is that it's from. But this is a nice tool to have just to know that you don't have honey that's a very high water content as well. So that's kind of the basic tools that we have here. Let me show you what our extractor looks like so you can get some eyes on that. And that's really the whole setup that we have here to move through our extraction process, and then we'll get started extracting. So this is the extractor that we're gonna be using today. This is an extractor we've had for about a decade. It's a 12-frame Dayton extractor made here in the United States. And what I'll say about extraction equipment, as particularly extractors themselves, is if you're purchasing something, it's going to be an investment. This was about $1,300 or $1,400 when we purchased this originally. And it's an investment, and it's a long-term investment. So we bought this when we were essentially at about 10 beehives, and we knew that we were gonna be growing, and so we invested in something a little larger. We have outgrown this, and it is one of the bottlenecks in our operation. But this is a big investment, and so in order to go to the next stage, we're saving our money up to get something that's quite large so that piece of equipment can grow with us. And so just keep that in mind with this. This is a radial electric extractor. You'll see it has a control module right here, then where we operate the speed that this is operating at. Now, as far as whether you should get something that's electric or hand crank, if you're gonna be doing this for any period of time, the hand crank models, although they are fun and cheap, it's a lot of work. And if you're doing more than say 10 frames of extraction, which is one box, you're gonna want something that's electric. Whether it's a small 4-frame, 6-frame, something like that, maybe that's as much as you need. But if you plan on growing, I would say make a little bit of investment so that you get something that works well. Now, the other option that you have when it comes to extraction equipment is tangential versus radial. And I'm gonna show you what this looks like inside. This is a radial extractor. And really what you should keep in mind is the difference between the two is that radial extractors, when we look at the sidewall, the frames sit perpendicular to the sidewalls. So you're extracting, as this goes around as a centrifuge, you're extracting both sides at the same time. Tangential, if this is your sidewall, tangential, the frames sit parallel to the sidewall as they rotate. And what that means is that you're only extracting one side at a time. So you extract one side and then you extract the other. Now, the thing to keep in mind is a lot of those hand crank models, the smaller ones, are tangential extractors. So it's twice as much work to get the same amount of honey out because you've got to flip those frames. So those are things you need to consider when you're thinking about that. Let's take a look inside this extractor and see what this looks like.
Like I said, this is a 12-frame extractor. And what you can see is that the carriage inside of this allows your frames to sit, like I said, perpendicularly. And so that's how you're gonna load all of your frames. And then this whole carriage is gonna spin around. The honey's going to fly to the outsides of the extractor and then go down into the bottom. Once it comes to the bottom, there is a honey gate right here that allows you to open this up, and then it goes right into your bucket with your two-part strainer in it. Now,
okay, so the first tool I'm going to show you for uncapping is this tool right here. Let's take a look how this works. So you see that this is a about half capped frame right here. We're going to be dragging this along the capped areas of the frame, and what you'll see is that it picks up those cappings while keeping you nice and level across the wax with that back piece, and those cappings just come right off. Very nice little tool for that. When coming to this back side right here, you can see that it leaves a very nice clean cut, and those cappings will come off there. Those are nice pristine caps. That little area right there, and that's all uncapped right now. So the other thing I wanted to show you too, just while I'm showing you this piece right here, is the scratcher and the use of that. So you see, like up in these areas right here, I missed a couple spots here. These little spots that you miss, that's what this scratcher is really nice for. So you just come up here, scratch those little spots so that you get all of that wax capping off of there and that honey can fly right out. Let's take a look at one of our other tools. We'll look at the roller next to see how that works while we're uncapping. Okay, so the next one I'm going to show you is the roller. Now, this is a fully capped frame. There's a couple areas that are uncapped, but this is not completely drawn, but this whole middle area is capped. The roller. So what I said earlier is that the roller causes a lot of damage to the cappings. And what you see is, as I'm going over this, it picks up pieces of cappings. You just want to kind of perforate that, but if you don't perforate it enough, not all of the honey will come out. And so you end up running over this quite a bit to get all of that uncapped. And what you end up with is a lot of debris on the top of this right here. Not nearly as clean even as this tool that you saw here. So another option, but again, you're going to be dealing with a lot more wax on the back end as you're straining out that honey. So the last uncapping device I'm going to show you is the hot knife. So we've got a cap frame here. We're going to take this hot knife, and you can come up or down with it, but you'll basically see, oops, that it basically cuts these cappings clean off. Nice slow process as far as moving it down, but you get a nice even cut, and the tops of these are absolutely perfect. I mean, a colony is going to come right back in and refill this with honey because of how clean the cells are left. I've got a little low spot here at the top. That's what my scratcher is for. So I'm just going to come here, scratch that little area on the top, and this is ready to go into the extractor. Let's see what this looks like as we process this honey coming through the extractor now.
Okay, so here we are. We've got 12 frames loaded in the extractor. We're going to go ahead and close that up, and we'll start it off here at the speed control with the on button, and then you're going to slowly ramp this up in speed. If it is unbalanced, and it will be, we try to balance it as best we can when we load, but over time, as this rotates, you will start losing honey and it will become more balanced. So you start slow and then move your way up as the machine starts to smooth out. So I usually ramp up real slow. I'm going to wait till I see some wobble in the machine. Right about there, I'm going to stop and just kind of let it rotate. Now what's happening on the inside here is, like I said, it's a huge centrifuge, and you can see the honey in the frames is being thrown to the outside of the side, or to the sidewall, outside of the frames, and then it's running down the tank and will wind up at the honey gate right here. Well, we're empty it into a food grade 5 gallon bucket through our strainer. So I'm gonna let this run for a couple minutes, and then we'll show you what the process looks as it's coming out. So we have let our extractor run, and the frames have now had all the honey extracted out of them. And we now open the honey gate and allow this honey to go through our two-part strainer down here. So let's open this up. And you'll see in that honey, there's a lot of wax particles from, you know, whatever uncapping mechanisms you're using. You just saw a piece of a beef go through there. So, you know, a debris that's in your honey, this is going to strain it out. And at this point, this is raw honey in its finished form. So what ends up happening is that down in our bucket, you'll see that honey is starting to accumulate down in that bucket. That is the finished product right there. There is no other processing beyond that point that is necessary. Now, if you're at a commercial scale, a lot of commercial beekeepers, in all commercial beekeepers that I've ever met, because of the scale that they're at and how much honey they're going through, they actually use pressurized filtration systems to filter out all of this particulate. And they are able to use much finer filters instead of the strainer that we're using, much finer filters, which filters out everything. So as small scale beekeepers, you know, we're oftentimes looking for a raw honey. That's what a lot of our customers are looking for. At this point, you have raw honey using this method right here. And beyond this, you're just gonna bottle it at that point. And let me show you what we use, or what you can use as a small scale beekeeper to bottle. Once your honey has been strained, it goes into whatever you're using as a bottling tank. Now, as a small scale beekeeper, you're likely not going to use a large stainless steel tank. Now, we do have, and what we use for bottling, is a 15-gallon heat-jacketed bottling tank. And that allows us to heat the honey to about 85 degrees, which is still considered raw honey, but it allows the honey to flow much smoother, so that it makes bottling a lot easier. We also use a different style of bottler as far as a nozzle is concerned as well. But to get to, for real basics, all you need is this right here. This is a bucket, a 5-gallon food grade bucket. This happens to be a brewer's bucket. But what you see attached to the front of that is a honey gate. And it's the same exact thing that you saw on the extractor, but this allows you to put your honey in a 5-gallon bucket and then you can bottle from this gate. And the way it works is it just simply opens up and you can regulate the flow based on how closed that opening is. So that's the real basic thing that you need to put honey into bottles. Now, in general, you're going to let your honey sit for about a week in your bottling tank. And the reason for that is you're going to let air come out of the honey. It's being aerated as it's running or as it's coming out of the extractor. And so you want to let that air come out. And what you'll see is if you let it sit for about a week, you'll have a white film on the top of the honey. That's totally normal. That's oxygen coming out of the honey. So that's air coming out of the honey. And you want to let it settle for about that week, because if you bottle it right away, you're going to get that on top of the honey that your customers have. And most folks don't want that. Well, I hope you all enjoyed this video on small scale extraction. Extraction, you know, really doesn't have to be super expensive. Your biggest expense is going to be the extractor itself. But like you saw, we use a 5-gallon bucket for bottling. A lot of the tools, in addition to even the hot knife, you know, are under $100. And so there is an economical way to do harvesting at a small scale. And like I said, this is the method we've been using for the last decade, and we're running 70 hives at this point. So it is a scalable size that we're showing you in this video. Hope you enjoyed this, and we'll see you at the next one.